Although Null's origins remain a mystery, his home was the Void, a primordial realm that lies within the Abyss. It's said that after 6 multiverses had been destroyed, a celestial brought light into the Void, disturbing Null's endless slumber. Content with drifting in darkness, Null was abruptly awakened and approached by the Celestial, who offered him a place as the King in Black, ruler over part of the newly forming 7th multiverse. Enraged that they would dare bring light to his domain, Null rejected the offer with furious defiance. He forged the first symbiote, a necrosword, imbued with dark power strong enough to decapitate a Celestial. And that's precisely what he did, catching it off guard and displaying Null's true power. After slaying a Celestial, Null was cast deeper into the Void by the remaining Celestials, along with the severed head of his victim. He seized upon the dead Celestial's head, using its cosmic energy to create legions of symbiote dragons, all of which he commanded at will without the need for hosts. This energy fueled Null's dark creations, but also introduced a weakness. High temperatures and certain frequencies could destabilize them. From the Celestial head, he also forged a personal suit of symbiote armor, enhancing his power with the Necro Sword and making him an even more lethal force to confront. Fast forwarding to medieval Earth, 2 symbiote dragons, one black and one red, descended upon the planet to conquer it. Many speculate that these ancient dragons are the forebears of Venom and Carnage, providing the lineage and raw power behind these infamous symbiotes. By this point, Null had amassed a vast army of symbiotes, sending his dragons to conquer world after world, leaving fragments of themselves to create new hosts, all tethered to Null's dark hive mind. But upon reaching Earth, the dragons encountered a young Thor, whose godly might proved to be a strong resistance. The battle between Thor and the dragons was fierce and prolonged, with Thor unleashing his divine lightning at intensely high temperatures. With one powerful strike, Thor's lightning severed Null's connection to the Black Dragon, which caused Null's control over the hive mind to shatter. The result was catastrophic for Null's forces. The severed symbiote dragons dissipated into countless individual symbiotes, effectively breaking Null's direct influence. Meanwhile, Thor engaged the Red Dragon in an aerial battle, ultimately striking it down, where its massive form plunged into the depths of the North Sea. Seeking nearby hosts, the now scattered symbiotes merged with creatures who embodied honor and nobility. These new hosts introduced the hive to unfamiliar ideals, ultimately turning the symbiotes against Null. United by a desire to end his tyranny, they trapped him within the core of a new world they created, known as the Throne World, naming themselves Clintar, their word for cage. Separated from the celestial head he had once wielded, Null lost it to the cosmos, where it eventually became known as Nowhere, the ancient head used as a spaceport featured in Guardians of the Galaxy movie. Although some symbiotes remained loyal to Knull, the Clintar developed their own society and hierarchy, forging a powerful civilization and homeworld. No longer solely instruments of darkness, they emerged as a significant force in the universe, with a complex culture and newfound independence. Before Null lost control of the hive mind, symbiotes had established entire planets governed by their own complex societies. One of these planets, rich with life and energy, caught the attention of the Silver Surfer, who scouted worlds for Galactus to consume. Seeing this symbiote planet as suitable, the Silver Surfer summoned Galactus, marking it for destruction. Some symbiotes attempted to defend their home against the Surfer, but despite their numbers, they were no match for his cosmic might, and he laid waste to countless defenders. When Galactus arrived, he devoured the entire planet. Though the symbiotes could not save their world, their collective memory through the hive mind preserved the horror of this event. Forever marked by that day, they retained an eternal enmity toward both Galactus and the Silver Surfer, viewing them as mortal enemies who had brought ruin to their civilization. Enraged by the destruction of a symbiote homeworld, Null set out on a relentless pursuit of vengeance against both the Silver Surfer and Galactus. Driven by fury, he tracked down the Silver Surfer first, intent on making him pay for daring to aid in the obliteration of his creations. When the two finally met, the ensuing battle became a spectacle of Knull's immense power and cosmic abilities. In this clash, Knull wore his symbiote armor with the full might of his dark arsenal, summoning the eldritch energy of the abyss and manipulating darkness to engulf his surroundings. His necrosword, forged to cut through gods, clashed with the Silver Surfer's cosmic energy in a fierce display. The Surfer, though powerful, found himself tested against Null's ancient might and mastery of shadow. This encounter would not only cement Null's reputation as one of the cosmos's most dangerous beings, but also reveal the depths of his wrath and the lengths he would go to exact his revenge. Knull arrived to face the Silver Surfer with an army of 100,000 symbiote soldiers, encircling the Surfer like a dark tide poised to strike. As he stared down his target, Null's voice resonated with cold, calculated intent. "Don't worry, they're just spectators," he sneered. "I'm here to rectify your insolence. As for your master, I'll save him for last." The Silver Surfer, resolute and unfazed, prepared himself for the onslaught, standing silently but intently. Yet he couldn't help but feel a surge of curiosity, a rare feeling for one who'd traversed countless galaxies and faced unimaginable threats. Here was Knull, a being ancient and unknown, emanating a confidence that suggested he had the power and perhaps the ambition to challenge Galactus himself. The Surfer understood this encounter was more than a skirmish. It was the beginning of something far darker, as Knull sought not only vengeance, but to assert his dominion over the very forces of the cosmos. Knull initiated the battle with a calculated strike, throwing a punch and deliberately allowing the Silver Surfer to counter it. When the counter landed, it pushed Knull back a few feet, and yet he grinned the whole time, intrigued by the Surfer's strength. Drawing his infamous necrosword, Knull spoke, "Shall we begin?" What followed was an intense but brief clash, as Knull closed the distance between them, relentlessly pressing forward. His every strike brought him closer to dismantling the Silver Surfer's cosmic board, the source of his unmatched speed and power. The Surfer retaliated with blasts of cosmic energy, but Null's symbiote armor adapted in sinister ways, absorbing some blasts, or even shifting his form to create holes around his body, allowing the energy to pass harmlessly through. With each encounter, Knull revealed his mastery over darkness, displaying an almost playful indifference toward the power wielded by his opponent. The fight became a display not only of Null's physical dominance, but of his mastery over the primordial abyss itself. The battle raged on, with Null's relentless assault gradually overpowering the Silver Surfer. Encircling symbiotes watched with sadistic glee, their smiles mirroring Null's own twisted delight as he closed in, unleashing a brutal barrage that pushed the Surfer to his limits. Blow after blow landed, each more punishing than the last, until finally the Surfer set out in defiance, "End it!" Null's grin widened. He seized the Surfer by the neck, lifting him effortlessly before slamming him down with immense force, carving a 20-foot crater into the ground. The symbiotes hissed and laughed as dust and debris scattered. Knull leaned in, his voice chillingly calm. "I'm not here to kill you," he sneered. His eyes blazed with dark intent, promising a fate far worse than death, a fate that would ripple throughout the cosmos as a warning to any who dared challenge the God of the Abyss. Share, like, comment, and subscribe for part 2.